Coming up, we'll take a look at updates to Microsoft Stream, our intelligent video service in Office 365, and most recently now available in our small business plans too. We'll look at the new capability to create and stream live events, how you can easily create and publish video content with PowerPoint and Microsoft Stream, and if you're an admin, we'll show you updates to controlling who can create channels, upload content, and how Stream supports GDPR compliance, and more. Joined today by Vishal Sood from the Stream engineering team. Welcome.
Thank you. Very excited to be here.
So if you're not familiar with Microsoft Stream, it's part of Office 365 and Microsoft 365. It gives you a full-featured enterprise video platform that integrates into your other Office apps, and it's come a really long way since launch.
That's right. In this Office 365 app launcher, you will see a Microsoft Stream tile. You can just click on it, and that will take you to the Microsoft Stream homepage. From here, you can stay in the know, and you can see what's trending around you. You can also get to your followed channels and stuff like that. In addition to this, Stream also powers video across all of Office 365. Mm-hmm. So you can get to Stream videos from within Microsoft Teams, so you can pin a channel. You can also get to it from your Microsoft SharePoint site, so you can pin a channel on the SharePoint site. And finally, you can also watch videos inside Yammer. This lets you actually watch videos within your favorite apps without ever having to leave them. And with the new features in Teams, now you can record all your meetings inside Microsoft Teams, and when the meeting is over, the recording shows up in your conversation window, and you can click it and consume the meeting recording from right within Teams.
Right, and beyond on-demand video consumption with the latest live event announcement, we're also adding the ability to do live streaming of events or company meetings or town halls from Stream.
Yes, Microsoft Stream is bringing live events to Office 365 in a new modern way. Employee engagement is crucial to our customers in terms of building relationship between the leadership and the employees. And at Microsoft, we actually use a lot of this for our own leadership updates. For example, here is a recent meeting Satya did with our employees. And what you see here is Satya is talking to the employees, and we are using multiple different cameras. Like, this is the audience view, and now you'll see a wide-angle view. And these things tend to be highly produced experiences.
So this looks really great, but how do I set something like this up in Microsoft Stream?
Yeah, let me show you how. So in this case, I'm going to start inside Yammer. So Yammer is tends to be our outer loop, so where most of the time the leadership has a group set up where they reach out to the employees. So in this case, you can see there were some past town halls, and then some people have been asking questions.
Right.
And what you see also, which is new, is this create a live event button. Mm-hmm. If I click on this, it's going to take me into Microsoft Teams. And inside Teams, what it will launch me into is a new live dialogue. Here, I can set a title for this meeting. They just say Mechanics Monthly Update. And I am going to invite you to this, Jeremy, because I think both of us are going to participate in this update.
Okay.
So if I look for you in inside Teams, you'll see I found you here, and you are a presenter. I could actually switch you to be a producer or an attendee. In this case, since you are going to be actively presenting, I've marked you as a presenter.
Okay.
And then I'm going to click Next here, and you see two options here, a quick start and an external encoder. Mm-hmm. Now, if you go back to the Satya example, it was a highly produced experience. So in this case, we are actually going to use an external encoder because that's where you do the higher production experiences.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll come back to the quick start later. In this case, we'll start with external encoder and click schedule. And the meeting is ready to go now. So at this point of time, I'm actually going to publish it so that people in Yammer can see it, and we'll come back to that later.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to do now is hit join. So once I click join, it takes me to the Microsoft Teams experience. And what you see here, which is a couple of URLs on the right-hand side.
Mm-hmm.
So I am going to copy this URL, and I will use that later. And with that, I'm going to click Start Setup so that I can start prepping my encoder to be able to talk to Teams and Stream in the background in this case.
Okay.
So in this point of time, I'm going to launch my encoder, which this in this case is Wirecast.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, our customers can use whichever their favorite encoders are. And for a complete list of encoders we support in Stream, you can click on this link.
Okay.
In this case, I have set up Wirecast and is ready to go to save some time. But what you see I've done here is I have your camera, Jeremy, which is basically a camera hooked up via USB to my laptop.
Okay.
I have my own webcam, which is also connected. I've thrown a couple of logos, and I also threw in a lower thirds to talk about your name and your title.
Looks great.
So at this point of time, everything is set up. And as you can see, if I go to output and output settings, the URL I had copied from Teams, which was a Stream URL, actually is here now. So I've pre-configured that as well.
Right.
So we are ready to go. So in this case, I'm just going to hit this go live button now in Wirecast.
Mm-hmm.
So what this is now doing is sending the feed over to Teams and Stream under the hood so that we can now monitor it inside Stream and go live when we are ready to go live. So I'm going to switch again to Microsoft Teams. And in a few seconds here, you'll see the stream start showing up in my producer experience inside Teams. So I'm going to click OK here. and you can see you're talking and I can see it on the screen. Everything looks good at this point of time, so I'm going to hit start the event.
And this is really great because you're using the encoder in this case to capture this USB cam, but I could convert a studio camera from SDI, for example, to USB or capture other audio devices.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, the options and the choices are kind of plenty.
Yep.
So in this case, my event is now started. Mm-hmm. So at this point of time, what I would love for you to do, Jeremy, is just go to Yammer and see if you can see this event.
Okay, so I'm in Yammer and I can see actually there's a live event happening and I can see it here and I can also see it in group events. I'm going to go ahead and join within Yammer. And now the nice thing is this is going to load up so I can actually start having conversations maybe with my other colleagues or people in the company. So for example, if I write a message here looking forward to this, now when I post that, it's going to actually let me communicate effectively to the presenters or the producers of the event, maybe even answer my questions if I'm sitting far away from the presenters.
Yes, I mean, this is what we call engaging with employees, leadership connection. Right. So if you see here, I have the Yammer icon, I click on it, and as a producer, I can even see the questions coming in now. So it's not just limited to the audience. The producers can also get a sense of what's happening and react to that. I can pick a question to be answered and stuff like that.
Okay, so now you've got this all set up. What if you want to switch different camera angles or go from my camera to your camera? Is that possible with the encoder?
Yes, absolutely. And that's why we had actually set up two cameras before. So mm-hmm. I'm going to go back into my encoder, and with a simple click, I can just swap out your camera for my camera, and I can just start talking now. So as a producer, you're always in control. You can pick which camera, which feed, what you want to show by just clicking a few buttons here. And of right. course, like one thing to remember is this is always being live streamed across the internet and eventually getting deployed. So there's always a few seconds delay. So what you see here will take a few seconds to go back to the screen. So
okay, that makes sense. That way you can tell when you see this at home, there's a few seconds delay from what we're doing now versus what you see on my screen. Yeah. So beyond this, how do I go into stream or can I go into stream and watch the same live stream, a live event from that console?
Yeah, and once again, that's the beauty of all of this, right? So stream is actually powering all of the live streaming experiences in Office going forward. Mm-hmm. So what that means is, irrespective of whichever app I am in, I'm able to consume live streams now. So in this case, I am now in stream, and what you see is I'm actually showing myself. But I can also see the conversation that is happening in Yammer right from within stream. Mm-hmm. Similarly, I could be doing in Yammer, in Teams as well. So.
And I can create an event from stream as well?
Yes, you can. So if you just go to create here, you'll see create a live event, and it'll bring up the similar looking dialogue to what you saw earlier. And you can now just set up that name, description, times here, and then start doing your live event from within stream.
So now we've seen the live stream basically coming from our Yammer feed using stream, and we've used a third-party encoder. We've also shown what it looks like to create that event within stream. Now, what if I've got other presenters maybe that are using different machines that aren't kind of on the same site? Because in this case, I'm using my camera attached to your machine, but what if I'm in another city or another country?
Yes, so in this case, I'll show you a different path to do that. So once again, I'm going to start in Yammer like I did last time, mm-hmm. and I'm going to click the Create a Live Event. And this launches me into Teams. So what you see here now is I can just do the same things I did earlier. I would call it Mechanics Monthly Update again, 2. So I'm going to add you here, and once again as a presenter, and go next. Last time when we were here, we picked the external encoder option.
That's right.
Now I'm going to show you the quick start option.
Okay.
So this is great for remote presenters and also things like which don't require a highly produced experience, but I just want to go live easily. So I'm going to pick this. And what this does under the hood is it uses Teams as your encoder. The reason that is great is you already know how to do meetings in Teams, how to pull participants, and I can use all of that to now just start broadcasting those.
Okay.
So I'm going to click schedule here. It will set things up. It'll take a few seconds here. And just like last time, you see now the event is all set up. Mm-hmm. I can hit publish so that other people can see it. And what I will do next is the same thing I did last time. I'm going to join the meeting as a presenter. So it pulls up my camera, which is the webcam in my computer. I can, and everything looks good. I can turn my audio on. In this case, we'll keep it off and just join. And now it's connecting me to the meeting. And what very soon you will see is Teams will take me to a production experience, which was kind of a simpler experience compared to what we saw in Wirecast last time. In this case, I can click on what content I want to show mm-hmm. and add my video feed to that, and I can send it to live. And what this gives me is an opportunity to see if everything is working fine, which it is, and I'm going to start the event right here. And now at this point of time, as soon as this is done, everybody in this world can start seeing my feed, and I can start talking about the monthly updates we're going to talk about in this show. So And all of that is set up. And now in this case, what I'll also do is I'd like to invite you, because I added you as a presenter.
Right.
Can you go to your Teams and see if you can join this meeting?
Yeah, and remember, I'm actually in a different city, maybe a different country than you are right now, not next to you on stage here. But I'm going to go ahead and go into my Meetings tab here within Teams. And I can see that I've got this new meeting that just popped up, Update 2. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And what that's going to do is it's going to show me, like any other meeting, I can participate in. I'm going to click Join. And now I can see that's going to fire up my camera. There I am. And I can go ahead and click Join now. What that's going to do is allow Vishal effectively to see my camera feed from within his console.
Yeah, now switching back to my screen, what you see now is I have been prompted by Teams that Jeremy is actually there now, so I can admit him. And once I admit Jeremy, his video feed shows up for me in the screen. And let's say this is the right time to switch over to Jeremy so that he can really talk about updates. I can click on that, and you'll see Jeremy's feed comes up in my preview window. Mm-hmm. If I like it, I can send it to live. And now I've simply, just using Teams, bought in a remote presenter, and they're actually presenting in a live broadcast manner to all the employees in the company now.
Right, and me as a presenter, I can see also that my camera's live here in the corner. It says live. There's a red outline around it, so I know that my camera's the hot camera at that point.
Great. And once again, just like before, I can watch this event on Teams, and I can watch it in other places like Yammer and all that kind of stuff as well. And with that, I think I'm going to just end this event because we've shown what we wanted to show.
So we've seen how you can initiate a live stream then using Yammer. You can use Stream. You can use Teams to start the meeting, also consume the meeting as an attendee from all these different apps.
Yes, that is correct. So Stream is basically a core capability in Office 365 that powers live streaming experiences across all of Office apps. So in this case, we show it starting in Yammer, but you don't have to start in Yammer. You can pretty much start in any of these three apps and complete your stuff there.
And something else that you can do that's pretty powerful with Stream is really integrate and record presentations from within PowerPoint so you can get content out to the rest of your colleagues, the rest of your organization very quickly, just with your webcam basically in a PowerPoint.
Yes, let me show you this because this is one of my favorite capabilities. If you know how to do PowerPoint slides, now you can create pretty good looking videos out of the box.
Okay.
So in this case, I have opened up a PowerPoint template which I created and I'm in the recording tab in this case.
Now the recording tab, if you're not familiar how you get that running, basically I'm gonna go into Files here, the File menu, and then I'm gonna click on Options. And what that's going to do is it's going to bring up a customization screen for PowerPoint. I'm going to customize the ribbon here, click on recording. Now, hopefully, I should see the recording tab. There it is. And now I can do all the things that Vishal is showing from within my copy of PowerPoint.
So coming back to PowerPoint here, what you see is we have a record slideshow option. We also have screen recording option. So I've leveraged all of those in this case. So if I go to slide number 3 here, you see this is a video instead of PowerPoint slide. And I created this video by doing a screen capture of what is happening in Stream. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just show you the new capability in Stream, which is in PowerPoint, sorry, which is Publish to Stream button. If I click Publish to Stream button, it brings me these options. From here, I can give this video a title and a description. I can also choose whether I want everybody in the company to be able to watch this video or I can also upload the original PowerPoint with this video. And I'm going to hit Publish here, but I'm not going to wait for this and go back to Stream and show you what's happening inside Stream.
And this is really great because basically what this enables you to do is kind of close the loop. You could have recorded with PowerPoint before using PowerPoint itself. You could have maybe even published it to web. This lets you publish it to your organization, give the permissions, and even upload the slides themselves right into Stream.
Yep. We're not only just hosting the PowerPoint for you. We are not just only converting it to a video. We're also doing the standard thing Stream does in this case. So if you see this video that got generated from PowerPoint, and if I play it, so you see my screen recordings are playing inside the video. From here, if I switch slides, you will see the slide transition, which will happen in a second. And in the meantime, you see me inking on the slide. So I can use the standard inking stuff in PowerPoint to do mm-hmm. that.
And it's done speech to text conversion, and we can see on the right.
Yes, so you saw the slide transition, you saw the animation bullets, and then you see the transcript on the right hand side. So from here, I can even now search whatever was said in the PowerPoint and go to that point in the video.
So with what you've shown us, we're really making it easy to create content, whether it's a live stream or something that you've done in PowerPoint. But beyond that, we're also making it easier from a consumption and discovery experience for users.
Absolutely. So in this case, we have launched a brand new feature, which is called spotlighting. So if you see this is a stream portal for Microsoft. And you see this video from Satya has been spotlighted by the admin on the homepage.
Mm-hmm.
So from here, employees can get to the right content much more easier now because the company is telling them what they should be watching because it's important for them.
Okay.
In addition to that, within a group as well, so if I go to the employee Q&A from CEO Connection group from Satya, you will see the admin will also spotlight some specific videos in that group. So in short, you can basically spotlight at a homepage or you can spotlight at the group page. And in that way, you can offer a very curated experience for your consumers in that space. And also beyond that, we're also doing some things around making the improving the quality of the transcription and the people detection in the video.
Okay.
So Stream, as you know, cognitively is able to figure out who all were in the video. So what we are offering new now, and this is the earlier part has been there forever, but new part here is being able to curate this timeline. So,
okay.
So in this case, I'm going to hit edit here. And what that will let me do is it will show me all the faces that Stream might have found out, even if there were people in the audience or in the background. And now I can basically go ahead and hide some of those people if I think they're not the relevant folks. And in some cases, I can also take a couple of people who were detected as different people and actually go ahead and merge them. So in this case, I'll take the number 2 and number 3 here, which seem to be the same person, click merge. Stream lets me pick which is the right image to pick, and I pick one of them, and I can merge. Similarly, along the transcript side, I can actually go to the transcript, click on edit, and there's an inline editor now. So I can actually improve any mistakes and actually make the transcript better.
So lots of great updates for viewers and content creators, but let's switch gears and talk about the admin experience. So one question, how do I do the spotlighting that we saw earlier? And also, what are some of the other admin updates that we've done?
Cool. So in this case, I am an admin on the system. So just like before, I can click on my profile and click on admin settings.
Mm-hmm.
So very first thing you'll notice is a completely different layout. It's very different from what we had earlier. And let me answer the specific question you had and then get into the other details.
Okay.
So to spotlight videos as an admin on the homepage, I can go to this section called Spotlight Videos. And as you see, the one video we saw spotlight earlier is actually here.
Mm-hmm.
Now to add another video, I can either paste a URL or search for the title of the video.
Okay.
In this case, I'm going to paste a URL I had copied another Satya video.
Right.
And you see Stream went ahead and confirmed that is this the video you really want to add? If so, I can click on it. And here we go. I've added another video to Spotlight.
Okay.
And what I can now do is I can also reorder this. If I wanted to place this video ahead of the other video, I can just simply do that and hit save. I won't show you go back to the homepage, but as you can imagine, you'll see this video show up on the homepage.
Right.
In addition to that, we also have some more content creation options. So
okay.
You can individually pick who can upload videos as well as who can create channels.
And both these are basically using allow list technology.
That is correct. Yes.
Okay.
So we are. When you turn this to on, I can pick a set of people who can do this.
Okay.
And the other thing I want to talk about is usage. So the obvious question for the admin is, how do I know how much of it am I using?
Mm-hmm.
So in this usage details section, now you can see what percentage of the total storage quota you're using. And not only that, I can also choose to be notified when I hit a certain threshold, and then Stream will notify me and tell me that you're getting close to that threshold, or you just hit that threshold, so I can take corrective action before it's too late.
All right, so we've done a lot of work at Microsoft around data privacy and things like GDPR. It looks like we've done some work here in Stream.
Yes, absolutely. So Stream is now GDPR compliant. We announced it along with our 25th May announcement. So if you go back to this, we have a new section called data privacy.
Mm-hmm.
And there are really two things we added here. One is right to information. So here, as a user, as an admin, I can now go ahead and type in any user's name. In this case, I can just search for you, Jeremy. Now, what this will do is it'll export all the activity you have had in Stream and all the data related to that
mm-hmm.
in a consumable CSV format, and it's already available. I can now download this and actually basically share with Jeremy what all he has been doing in the Stream portal should he request for that information.
And if I want to be forgotten then, using Right to be Forgotten, how would I do that in Stream?
Yeah, so I won't show you that, but I'll show you where it happens. So in this case, I am in this manage deleted users.
Mm-hmm.
So the way this works is typically when somebody says, I want to be forgotten, you go ahead and delete them in Active Directory. And
right.
when that happens, Stream actually shows you a list of all the people who have been forgotten.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't want to delete one of us from the Active Directory to do this demo, so I'm going
right.
to skip that.
Right.
But I'll see my name here, and then I can say, OK, forget me from Stream. And then Stream will erase all your association, all your comments, all your likes, and all your views from Stream, and forget you, essentially.
Are we going to see even more infusion of AI then coming to Stream? That's something else that's been important to Microsoft.
Yes, I all I can say is you watch the space, and we'll keep you posted on that. But we're expecting some more stuff.
Will do. So if you're watching this, how can people get started with Microsoft Stream?
If you have Office 365 or Microsoft 365, you can go to stream.microsoft.com. There you'll soon see the ability to create live events. If you don't see it there already, to get live events working, your admin will need to enable your service and allow your account.
So lots of great updates. Thanks for joining us today, Vishal. Thank you for watching at home. And if you haven't already, click on the gear, subscribe to Microsoft Mechanics, and we'll see you soon.